It's tearing up my heart when I'm with you. But when we are apart, I feel it too. And no matter what I do, I feel the pain. With or without you.
Hey guys, this is probably the biggest Mandela discovery yet. I wanted to share it with you tonight. Hey guys, good evening and welcome to my exciting channel. We're discussing Mandela effects and the like. Thanks for joining me today as we uncover the mysteries of the Mandela effect itself and find out the true meaning of it all. We must discover what is really happening, what is really going on here to change these things that we know and hold dear to us. And let us help others discover the meaning of the Mandela effect and how it affects them and the price of milk. Thank you. Be sure to hit the like and subscribe down below. Hey guys, what is up? I hope you all are having a great Mandela Effect night. Hope everything's working out for you guys to the best. I just discovered a huge Emmy, and let me tell you about this one, okay? Because I tried to step away from the Mandela Effect, and this crap just finds me, okay? I was sitting down, we were watching the astronaut's wife. And in the movie, there's this storybook that the woman's reading to, I guess, her pupils, her class. She's a teacher, and she was reading the Brothers Grimm, or Grimm stories. And I was tossing it up in my head. Was it Brothers Grimm, Grimm's Brothers? But while I was doing that, something told me to research Ronald Reagan's speech. And Ronald Reagan, June 12th, 1987, if you listen to his speech now, it has miraculously or magically, however you want to say it, not miraculously, it's been magically changed through time. There's residue, plenty of residue to support this. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall, okay? I remember that. Mikhail Gorbachev, I didn't remember the exact year of the speech. I had to look that one up. June 12, 1987. Which was basically about Russia and relations with the United States and the Berlin Wall between East and West Germany. And it was a call from Ronald Reagan to Mr. Mikhail Gorbachev, tear down the wall, okay? The wall of that brought freedom. So let me just play the speech for you so you can hear it. So check this out. It changed. Now he says, tear down this wall. Listen.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
No, not in my reality. That's changed. And there's plenty of proof. If we go, let's see, here's one on Facebook. There's Mr. Pope, tear down that wall, right? It's a meme. Calm, there was a keep calm here. It said keep calm and Mr. Gorbachev. And by the way, I'll spell it for you guys in a little bit. Keep calm and Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall. See that? June 12, 1987, how the tear that down wall speech was nearly torpedoed by the State Department. Okay, check that out. And this is an online quiz I found. Who said Mr. Gorbachev tear down that wall? It says, was it Kennedy, Reagan? And they spelled Reagan wrong, by the way. It's R-E-A. Clinton, Obama. Ronald Reagan is the answer. let's see. This is from redstate.com. And by the way, I have Residue Hunter Teresa here with me. Say hello, Teresa.
Hi, everyone. Good evening.
Hey. She's finding me all kinds of residue. You guys see that? There's like 30 tabs open.
I love residue.
It's ridiculous. So June 12, 1987, how the tear that wall down speech was nearly torpedoed. Okay, that's from redstate.com. Okay, so let me just talk a little bit about for a second. On June 12, 1987, President Ronald Reagan was scheduled to give a speech at the Brandenburg Gate at the border of East and West Berlin. It was a time of political ferment. Gorbachev's glasnost and perestroika were the beloved idols of the Western left, but behind the scenes, the KGB and the GRU continued their bad old ways of generating dissension. Yep. What do we see today? We see the same thing. And defeating and defeatism in NATO, Reagan already cast in the role of a cold warrior, meaning the Cold War, was a step with the times. The Germans, he was told, had already heard the anti-communist stuff until they were sick of it, and it was perceived that Gorbachev might be politically weakened if Reagan went after him too hard. See, but here's the thing: the speechwriter was Peter Robinson, assigned to produce a draft. Right? He was told only that the president would speak at the Berlin Wall. There would be a large crowd, and he probably ought to talk about foreign policy. So let's see. So it was, you guys get that. It was Peter Robinson, who wrote that speech. Let's see if I could find it. Okay, there's two places where it says it. Yeah, it's funny how it's called the tear down that wall speech, but in the speech he actually says this now. It's so weird. It's almost like that Mr. Rogers neighborhood where he says it's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, but he used to say it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and I remember that clearly. This is another one. Teresa sent me tear down that wall. It was a concert held at U.S.-Mexican border. What is all this emphasis on the wall? And by the way, there's an old episode from the 1950s. It actually depicted this guy named Trump putting up a wall to protect the people from the aliens. Do you remember the name of that, Teresa?
I'm sorry.
I can't remember the name of it, but if anyone wants to put it in the comments, that's great. You'll get extra credit for that one. It was in the
I apologize.
1950s. Starts with a T. I can't remember.
What is it about? I'm sorry, what was it about?
I could look it up real quick. I'll do it afterward. Let's see.
Are you
Detroit.
sure?
Yeah, that's fine. I don't want to get sidetracked. We got so much to talk about. When Ronald
Oh,
Reagan
okay.
tore down that wall, right? This is by Nicholas G. Hahn, Detroit News. When Ronald Reagan tore down that wall, this is the same article. Okay, just it's only found one time, but you see, it should have been this wall. That's the same one from Red State. Sorry about that, folks. See that I get bombarded with residue. It's awesome though. It's awesome. The spirit leads me to find these things. So Peter M. Robinson. Check it out. Hoover Institution tearing down that wall research. Okay? And I have another issue, which I'll talk about that in a little bit. I wanted to talk about 1985 movies to see if you guys remember Rocky IV coming out in 1985. I don't remember that. Let's see. Tearing down that wall. Hoover Institution. That's the article. Okay, well, there's that passage about tearing down the wall. Reagan said that wall has to come down. That's what I'd like to say. So, this is YouTuber Beraldo. In his title, he says, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall. It's a forklift driving through a wall. Nothing too crazy about that, right? When Ronald Reagan told Gorbachev, tear down that wall, what did this wall divide? Okay, and it's one of those ABCD things, multiple choice. The rich and the poor, the East Bloc and the Western Bloc, the communism and democracy, the rebels and the empire. Which one is it? I'm sure you guys know the answer to that. There's even a song, Tear Down That Wall, that, and so you'll have to excuse the imagery. With the fingers. I'm sorry about that, folks. Tear down that wall. Thank you, Teresa, for sending stuff. Now this is the Ronald Reagan Wayne Bosinger, he puts here Ronald Reagan tear down that wall speech 1987. So let's see if I want to
Let
quote this.
security go together, for we believe in openness. We welcome change and openness.
We welcome change and openness.
For we believe that freedom and security.
For we believe that freedom and security
go together.
Go together.
That the advance of human liberty.
That the advance of human liberty.
The advance of human liberty can only strengthen.
The advance of human liberty can only strengthen.
The cause of world peace.
The cause of world peace.
There is one sign the Soviets can make.
There is one sign the Soviets can
make that would be unmistakable.
That would be unmistakable.
That would advance dramatically.
Wait, hold on. That would advance what?
That would advance dramatically.
Dramatically,
the cause
of freedom and peace.
General Secretary Gorbachev.
General Secretary Gorbachev.
If you seek peace.
If you seek peace.
If you seek prosperity.
If you seek prosperity for the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe.
If you seek liberalization.
If you seek liberalization.
Come here to this gate.
Come here to this gate.
Mr. Gorbachev.
Mr. Gorbachev.
Open this gate.
Open this gate. Not over yet, folks. Okay. Clapping. It's only a few more seconds here.
Mr. Gorbachev. Tear down this wall.
Tear down this wall, he says. That's what he says now.
It's supposed to be that, isn't it?
It's supposed to be that wall.
Yeah.
Ronald Reagan, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall speech. Here's another one.
This gate. Namely the elimination of such weapons.
This is from speakers.com. Okay, folks, listen.
On both sides, days of protests, like mark this fact. Because today, we have within reach the weapons from the face of the earth. As I expensive weapons, and the Western allies have national war, and to place a total ban on we have also proposed there were difficult capital in Europe. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
This wall, he says. Yeah, right there. It's supposed to be that wall. This is actually, it's about a 3-minute speech. But I suggest you all look it up and check it out. This is a residue. A little kid says it. Check this out. And, of course, his father's encouraging him. Listen.
Tear that wall.
What did Mr. Gorbachev say?
What did Mr. Gorbachev say?
Tear that wall.
Tear that wall.
Tear
that wall. Good job. High five. That's funny. Let's see. Daily reminder, Gorbachev tear down that wall. And that Nazi Germany lost the war and Hitler offed himself. Take your broken ideologies elsewhere. This is by Robert Davis, August 15th, a couple days ago. Your kind is not welcome here. Okay. This post is from Sharon Panglebaker. Reagan said tear down that wall because he recognized it as a symbol of hate. 45 wants to build a wall, same sentiment. When Reagan told Gorbachev, Mark Conter, 15 hours ago, when Reagan told Gorbachev to tear down that wall, was he cleansing history? Vote responsibly. Erica Ruby, the Trumpers. Oh, and by the way, I also have to thank Harold on this one, okay? Harold Beeb for helping me out. He remembered it clearly as well, 100%, like I did. Let's see, Erica Ruby, the Trumpers. Got it, Clint, make my day, Gorbachev. Tear down that wall. Another one, Alan Orr. President Reagan was known for telling the world, tear down that wall. Okay? There's more, but I'm not going to read it all. Let's see. From the words of former U.S. President Ronald Reagan, tear down that wall. And this is the one about the speechwriter. I think I read from that earlier. This is from politico.eu. Reagan said, okay, General Secretary Gorbachev, Reagan said, if you seek peace, if you seek prosperity for the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe, if you seek liberalization, come here to this gate. Mr. Gorbachev, open this gate. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall. It's supposed to be that wall. That's weird. Look at this. Because it says here, the speechwriter who helped Reagan tear down that wall. It's bizarre. Paula Morgan says, why do you constantly play the Ron Reagan statement about Gorbachev tear down that wall? It's really annoying. I think they're pointing to something here. There's residue all over the place. This is a few books here. Where Have All the Leaders Gone? By Lee LaCocca. He says here, one of the most inspirational... Wait, hold on. I gotta go up a little bit. I'll go one step further. Even if everybody agreed that a wall was a workable solution, what the hell are we doing building walls? America doesn't build walls, it tears them down. One of the most inspirational moments of the last 25 years was when Ronald Reagan stood up and said, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall, and the Berlin Wall came tumbling down. I'm getting a call, folks. Hold on one sec. Oh, hi, Rena.
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah. I am on my new headset, that's why I wasn't sure.
Oh, okay. Well, listen, there's that speech, the famous Ronald Reagan speech. Do you remember him saying, tear down that wall?
I do.
And now he says tearing down this wall. That's nuts.
Oh, my God. I know, when he said that, tear down that wall, I'm like, he said that wall.
He pointed to it and he said, tear down that wall.
That wall. Yeah.
It's changed spiritually. That's what I'm trying to tell you, folks. This one was revealed to me tonight. I'm telling you. I found plenty of residue. Teresa's here too. She found me a bunch of residue, Rena. I'm actually recording right now. What I'm showing everybody. It says this in this book. This is the book on. What were you saying? I'm sorry.
I just said hi to Teresa. Sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
Sorry.
Teresa, you there?
No, I'm in here, French fries.
Oh, okay. Check.
Sorry.
Yummy. I want some.
I'm eating a little dinner.
I want some French fries. Hey, this book says, this is The Rebellion of Ronald Reagan, A History of the End of the Cold War, right? Because that ended the Cold War when that wall came down. Let me read it right here. The secretary... Hang on. Okay, I have to go up a little bit. Okay, this is important, very important history. A few days after the Powell meeting, the dispute was elevated to the very highest level of the Reagan administration, while White House Chief of Staff Howard Baker called Griscom into his West Wing office for a session with Secretary of State George Shultz, with a T. The secretary said he had problems with the Berlin speech. He was concerned that if Reagan delivered the line urging Gorbachev to tear down the wall, it could set back the progress that had been made so far in improving relations between the United States and the Soviet Union. Indeed, such a speech might even jeopardize Gorbachev's position and the domestic reforms he was carrying out. Shultz, in an interview for his book, said he did not recall making such an argument. I can't imagine anyone objecting to him making that statement, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall, Shultz said. See? Griscom responded that Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall, was the best line in the whole speech. What?
Wow.
That's weird how it flips on you. That's like that picture. That's like that picture that I shared that actually had. I'll have to go back to it. But there's a meme that I found that says Gorbachev. It says tear down that wall, and in one of the content it says tear down this wall. So weird.
That is really strange.
There's a couple more I got to share. Because it's time.
Everything.
The truth will set you free, not make you free. It will set you free. It's time.
Right.
It's time truth speaks. Spencer Leake, Sr. In this book, he writes, America should look to as a means. Hang on. It would be unconstitutional to utter the name of Jesus as one that America should look to as a means of setting up the process of restoration after 9/11. Well, if there is a wall that separates the spiritual from the secular, I must say to you what Ronald Reagan said to Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall. If there is a wall that separates the spiritual from the secular in our school systems, then I say, tear down that wall. And just like in the Republican and Democratic Party, okay, it says if there is a wall separating the Democratic Republican Party from the Jesus Christ Party, then I say, Mr. Obama, tear down that wall. Another book,
wow.
Passion, yeah, it's crazy, Passion Play by Sarah Rule.
Oh, no.
What? What
you
is
know
it?
The logo LG, like, you know, the phone, LG?
Yeah, I think the eye shifted down. The left eye shifted down. I saw
no,
that.
LG. LG. The G has an arrow on it now.
Oh, no way. It didn't have an arrow.
Yes, way. The G, LG, which means life's good, the brand, which they make cell phones and stuff. The G is now an arrow like Goodwill and Target. Yep, I just noticed it now.
Oh, wow. This stuff is happening fast, guys. We have to stay on top of it. Okay.
They keep coming to me. What do you want me to do?
I know. Let me finish. I'm almost done. I got a few more to share. I was at
Sorry.
Mr. Gorbachev's over there in Moscow. I know.
Sorry.
His son's goal. It's okay. His son's goldfish died. I replaced it. You think history is made by great wheels set in motion? Well, it is. But it's also made by small acts of generosity. I replaced a little boy's goldfish and a wall came crumbling down. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall. Why would so many people remember it wrong? Let's see.
Wow.
Haunted by the Holy Ghost. Look at this. Haunted by the Holy Ghost, Memoirs of a Reluctant Prophet by Charles Kikar. Look at this. Border walls. What would Jesus do? St. Paul tells us that in Christ, God has broken down the dividing walls of hostility. Robert Frost in Mending Walls. I like Mending Walls. I should read that poem. Something there is about a wall that wants it down. Ronald Reagan demanded Mr. Gorbachev tear down that wall. You know, I've heard that good fences make good neighbors. But and this is Ronald Reagan. This is a clip that I found. Actually, my mom found this one. Ronald Reagan, President Reagan, tear down that wall, and he actually does say tearing down that wall. It's weird. You have to listen to it. It's 39 seconds, so bear with it.
I know
listen.
That over the years, many of you have seen the pictures and news clips of the wall that divides Berlin. But believe me, no American who sees firsthand the concrete and mortar, the guard posts, and machine gun towers, the dog runs, and the barbed wire can ever again take for granted his or her freedom or the precious gift that is America. That gift of freedom is actually the birthright of all humanity. And that's why, as I stood there, I urged the Soviet leader, Mr. Gorbachev, to send a new signal of openness to the world by tearing down that wall.
Isn't that weird?
Today I said... I know that over
you guys heard him. You guys heard him say. He said, "Tearing down that wall."
Yeah.
And something interesting about the assassination. Okay. We know. Let's put this in motion with the timeline. Okay. We're looking at 1987. June 12th is when he delivered that speech. Tear down that wall, which is now tear down this wall. I'm making residue here. The attempted assassination of Ronald Reagan. Everybody should know this who was a child of the 80s or 70s even, or before that. On March 30th, 1981, Ronald Reagan, the 40th president of the United States, and three others were shot and wounded by John Hinckley. His last name is spelled H-I-N-C-K-L-E-Y, and he's junior, okay? In Washington, D.C., as they were leaving a speaking engagement at the Washington Hilton Hotel, Hinckley's motivation for the attack was to impress the actress Jodie Foster. And remember, Ronald Reagan was an actor. And they even mention that in Back to the Future. If you watch the Back to the Future movie, Doc, he's carrying some plans for something, and he mentions Ronald Reagan, the actor. Let's see, over whom he had developed an obsession after seeing her in the 1976 film Taxi Driver. Okay. Let's see, there were no immediate fatalities in the aftermath of the attack. Reagan was shot in the chest, just below the left underarm. He suffered a punctured lung and heavy internal bleeding, but prompt medical attention allowed him to recover quickly. No formal invocation of presidential succession took place, although Secretary of State Alexander Haig, H-A-I-G, falsely stated that he was in control here, while Vice President George H.W. Bush, there it comes up again, which, returning to Washington, I believe they're part of, some of these people are part of the deception, I'll just say that, I won't say names. White House Press Secretary James Brady was the most seriously wounded victim. He was left paralyzed from a gunshot wound to the head. See, I don't want to, okay, I want to talk about Hinckley's motivation. This is important. Again, the assassination attempt was March 30th, 1981. Hinckley's motivation, due to erotomania, whatever that is, Hinckley's motivation for the attack was born of his obsession with Jodie Foster. Okay, that's what it was. While living in Hollywood in the late 1970s, he saw the film Taxi Driver at least 15 times, apparently identifying strongly with Travis Bickle, the lead actor portrayed by Robert De Niro. The arc of the story involves Bickle's attempts to protect a 12-year-old child prostitute named played by Foster. Wait a second, guys. Who was the sunblock girl? Wasn't it Jodie Foster, the sunblock girl? Yeah, look it up real quick. I think it was the one. It starts with a C. Coppertone. She was the.
Oh,
Jodie Foster was the Coppertone girl.
Oh, with a dog.
Yeah, she was the one. And by the way, I might add that may be a Mandela. It's showing her butt now. It's the Coppertone logo, or actually not logo, but the picture with her in it has her part of her butt like showing. It didn't used to have that. It wasn't as showy. You remember it showing all the way? You remember her butt showing?
Well, not all the way. Yeah.
Well, a part of the way. You could see a tiny part, but now they show it almost all the way.
Not the full butt, but what? I don't know. That's kind of messed up.
Oh, wow. Check this out. Okay. In the film with, In that film. Towards the end of the film, Bickle attempts to assassinate a U.S. senator who is running for president. Over the following years, Hinckley trailed Foster around the country. He was stalking her, going so far as to enroll in a writing course at Yale University in 1980 after reading a People magazine that she was a student there. So Hinckley, here's the thing. Hinckley was convinced that he would be Foster's equal if he became a national figure. He decided to emulate Bickle from the movie, which was played by Robert De Niro. Okay, so if he figured he would get her attention if he did this. Hold on. So Hinckley was convinced. He decided to emulate and began stalking President Jimmy Carter. He was surprised at how easy it was to get close to the president. Wow, he was only a foot away at one event, but was arrested in October of 1980 at Nashville International Airport for illegal possession of firearms. Carter made a campaign to stop here, but the FBI did not connect the arrest to the president and did not notify the United States Secret Service. So his parents briefly placed him under the care of a psychiatrist. Hinckley subsequently turned his attention to Ronald Reagan. Okay, so originally, assassination attempt was going to be on Jimmy Carter, but then he changed over to Ronald Reagan. Okay, whose election
I got your information.
What's that?
Cherry Brand was the official first Coppertone girl in the Germany invaded in 1959. In 1993, Alexis DeGree became one. Later, Jodie Foster was in one of the commercials. Due to changes in perceptions in society, the original trademark girl is no longer available.
Okay. Yeah.
That clear that up?
That clears it up. Yeah, that, I mean, as a parent, if my daughter was that doing, like, that much showy, I can't believe they let her do that. You know what I'm saying?
I actually sent you the original one. If you left that,
this is so messed up.
The original one. I sent you the original one.
I know. In my next clip, I'm going to be sharing with you part of the assassination video. I'm not allowed to share all of it because it's going to be copyrighted. I know it. That's actually what...
That's copyrighted.
Yeah, I know. And it came from a news channel. That's, of all places, they don't want you to share the assassination attempt. A lot of people say it may have changed. So everybody, keep a close eye on these things. All right, that's all I'm trying to tell you. Anyway, guys, thanks for checking me out, and have a great Mandela Effect night, and God bless.
They put you here, and they run around like you come.